For non-factored question answering system. The goal of query performance prediction or QPP in IR is predicting the effectiveness of a reasonable model for a given query. QPP approaches are partitioned into two groups, pre-retrieval and post-retrieval approaches. Pre-retrieval approaches focus on the query context and the statistic of collection. However, post-retrieval approaches take into account the results. Here we focus on post-retrieval approaches given their superior performance to pre-retrieval models. QPP has been extensively explored in the context of ad hoc retrieval and web search, but here we only focus on performance prediction for non-factored question answering systems. So why this task is important? Similar to ad hoc retrieval, having an accurate and real-time performance predictors could potentially be used in triggering a specific action or giving feedback to users. But what's special about non-factored questions? Non-factored questions play a pivotal role in question answering systems since their technologies are not as mature as factoid questions. And also, new generation of search technologies, including conversational search, intensifies the importance of an effective and efficient QPP method because the output of this system is one single passage which must address the user's need, and this leaves almost no room for error. So, why QPP in ad hoc retrieval is technically a different task from QPP for non-factored question answering system? Many methods for predicting the performance for ad hoc retrieval are designed to predict recall-oriented metrics like NAM, but here the focus is on precision-oriented metrics. The notion of relevancy in ad hoc retrieval is different from the notion of relevancy in non-factored question answering system. In question answering system, a relevant passage should contain the exact answer, but relevancy in ad hocs means topical relevancy. So many methods for predicting the performance of ad hoc retrieval systems distinguish topical relevant documents from off-topic documents which cannot perform effectively for question answer systems. Some QPP methods in ad hoc retrieval rely on term distribution of top retrieved documents. This is why in question answer systems, the candidate answers are usually short sentence level or passage level, and they have little overlap with each other as well as the question. Some methods in ad hoc retrieval are rely on retrieval scores of top retrieved documents, but given the dominance of neural network approaches in QA systems, the scale and distribution of scores in different neural networks are different, and this can have a major impact in effectiveness of this method. So NQA QPP is a component-based neural network, and each component is inspired by the literature in QPP. We have a score-based component, which focuses on the scores of top retrieved documents. We have question-only component, which focuses on the question text, and question-answer component, which model the top retrieved documents, the result of this. And then we aggregate the output of each component in an aggregation layer and achieve the final score for prediction, for performance prediction. The score-based component model the scores of top retrieved documents. It takes the normalized scores of publicly document and get standard deviation and feed it to a fully connected network and learn a d-dimensional representation for that. The question only component represent the question text. We feed the question text into BERT, which is a state-of-the-art text representation model, and then we feed the output of that to a fully connected network and learn a bidimensional representation. In question answer component, we focus on a result list. So we concatenate each answer in a result list with a question, and then feed it to a BERT model followed by a feed-forward network. We repeat this and then we concatenate all this representation and feed it to another feed-forward network. We try to keep everything simple here. So the aggregation layer aggregates the results of all these components. We take the results of these components in different combination and then we produce a single real value. To evaluate our model, we use a two non-factoid data set, first antique, which is a data set that recently constructed in CIYR through crowdsourcing. It has 2,626 open domain non-factoid questions and about 34k minimum relevance annotation. And on average, each question has 8.5 relevance answer. And the second one, if you can search QA, it has 4,165 non-factoid questions based on Wikipedia and on average 1.5 relevant answers per question. For evaluation metrics, we compute the correlation between the predicted performance and the actual performance in terms of reciprocal rank. To do so, we use Pearson correlations and the Pearson correlation and Kendall's top correlation. So for results, there are too many numbers here, but don't worry, I don't want to look at all of them. Since we are not aware of any performance prediction method for non-factored question answering systems, we use performance prediction methods for ad hoc as our baselines, and we outperform all the baselines in all settings. So to conclude, we've shown here that QPP for non-factored QA is different from ad hoc retrieval, and nowadays QPP is becoming even more important given the growth in conversational search system, and the proposed method outperforms the baselines in all settings in the collection. Thank you, and come see our posters on the